Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Meg, and if you have been here for a while, welcome back. Today is very exciting for me, and excuse my grubby appearance, but I've just come back from a full day of working, and I got a notification from DHL that my package from Farfetch has arrived, and so here we are. So this is actually the first time I've ever ordered anything from Farfetch, and disclaimer, this is not a sponsored video, okay? They don't know who I am, I don't have any codes or whatever. But, as you can see that FF right there. And if you have been following me on Instagram, which by the way is The Secret Life of Bags, just like the name of this channel, then you would actually know what this is. I was very excited because I'm already unboxing it. This is a true unboxing. That is the box. Yeah. So anyway, when I saw this, I've been eyeing this here in Sydney, but I just couldn't stomach paying full price, which here in Sydney is $895. I know that in the States this is under $500, but still, I just couldn't get myself to do it. But I really like the design. Yeah, I thought, you know what? I'm gonna see if there's anywhere that's got it on sale, and lo and behold, Farfetch came through. This actually came from a boutique in France. So there we go. Sorry if that was ear piercing, but that's what it looks like inside. It's wrapped in tissue paper. There's some documents here. It's just like return labels, I guess. So we're gonna keep that because I don't know yet what's gonna happen after this unboxing. Right. It came in the, as you can probably already tell, it's an item from Coach. Okay. And it came in this sort of like satiny Coach dust bag, which is pretty much how all the other Coach dust bags are. Like, this is the one that's my Riley lunchbox, and I also have a wallet on chain, and it comes with the same high quality beautiful dust bag. Anyway, that's not what we're here for. We're here for the main event, which is dun 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 dun, just give me a sec. There we go, here we go. The unveiling of this beautiful what? Yes, that is the, I think this is called the Madison pillow bag. Yeah. So it still has all the tags. Yeah, it said Quilted Pillow Madison. Okay. And then it is in the color chalk, which actually on the website, the French boutique labeled it as white, but it's more of a, well, it's more of a chalk, really. I'm just doing a quick inspection. I see that there's sort of like a, you probably won't be able to see it. It's a black sort of like dot. And then there's another one here at the back. Now this beauty here, the camera is, or the lighting is washing it out, but this beauty here is made of lambskin. Yes, lambskin. The same material that Chanel is famous for, right? I'm going to change the lighting so that I can see, or I can show you this one up close, but also I'm going to be taking some shots of it in natural light tomorrow, because right now it's evening and I don't have any sun. That's why I'm using artificial light. I just do not have the emotional intelligence to actually wait to unbox this till tomorrow. So yeah, let me go ahead and adjust the lighting and then I'll show you the bag up close. So this is the bag up close. As you can see, it's all still tied up. It has this tag that says, please keep this label attached for returns. So if I take this off, I can't return it anymore, but I can unwrap this whole thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and actually do that. It comes with this beautiful chain strap that's got sort of like an old gold chain. See that? If you can focus, there we go. With interwoven leather, very Chanel vibe. And I know I've heard a lot of people sort of like compare this bag or say that it reminds them of the Chanel 19. Now, the beauty of this baby, as you can see, is it's got no Coach labeling except for the C, which I really like. It is the C from Coach that is covered in the same chalk leather. Okay, it has a turn lock feature, which I suppose is also one of the reasons why people say it makes them think of the Chanel 19. It features a hang tag. I'm not really a fan of this hang tag, one that's very puffy. Okay, it has got a back pocket, and I really like that this back pocket also has that magnetic closure there. So you could actually put some stuff in there. And just to show you, I've got my iPhone. This is the 12 mini, so I'm sure that this is going to fit. But because it's got a rather bulky case, I just want to see. Yep, fits perfectly well. Doesn't show any bulging. So great. That's fantastic. Now if I can just take it out again. There we go. Right. And then, since I've already opened that part, here we go. That's where it is. Beautiful. Nothing on there. It's got all the paper stuffing. It's got a flap here in the front, which is also magnetic. And that opens up to just a pocket. Okay, it's a little bit hard to show. Yeah, but open it up into a pocket, and this is lined with their microfiber material that feels kind of like suede. Right. Let me take out the stuffing so you can see what the inside looks like. Yeah. So there is one zipped pocket at the back, and then just the big compartment there. And like I said, it is lined with that microfiber material. Okay, so that's what that looks like. Now, the thing that I have seen a lot of people talk about that they don't like about this bag is, since I've removed the stuffing, it is now difficult. Well, I didn't find that much difficult, but it makes it a little bit difficult to close this if there is nothing inside. I'm seeing no problems with my, I don't have long nails like others do. I can already also see that there is a scratch on the leather here. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, but there is a small scratch there, which with this kind of material is pretty common. And you would probably see, oh, that looks like it's not gonna stand on its own. And this is not sagging, it's the puff of that. See how this side is also puffy? So it continues on like that. So that's why. Right. So I've always been wanting a white bag, and I thought, you know what? Let's get that. So this was actually, it retails for $895 here in Australia. And on Farfetch, it was $709. And then they had a 15% off on sale items. So I ended up paying $612 Australian dollars for this, including the $10 shipping. And I bought this 24th of June, which was last Friday. Today is Tuesday, the 28th of June. Yes, It only took them 4 days to ship this from France to me. Isn't that beautiful? Right, so this is the Quilted Pillow Madison unboxing, and I'm thinking that since there are people who are talking about this bag and comparing it to the Chanel 19, one of the videos that I want to do with this is a comparison of the two. Right, so you've got your Coach Madison and your Chanel 19. So, yeah, and just looking at them side by side, the Coach appears to be a little bit bigger. In terms of width, it's the same. In terms of depth, I think maybe the Coach is just puffy, so it looks a little bit thicker. But I can also tell, just side by side, that the Coach one is a little bit taller, right? But we'll get into an in-depth comparison of these two. Yeah, in the next couple of weeks, I'm going to use the Coach one first for a while, see how I feel about it. By saying this, it looks like I'm not gonna be returning it. Yeah, because I mean, after I took off the packaging on the chain and seen how beautiful it is and just felt how soft the lambskin is, I mean, how is it that Coach can create a lambskin leather bag for under $500 US? We'll do a comparison of the two at a later stage. I will be doing an individual review on this bag, and then I'm going to do a comparison between the Coach bag and the Chanel bag. So watch out for those videos. And thank you very much for watching this little unboxing. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment section down below. And when I do the comparison between the Chanel and the Coach, what features would you like me to focus on? And if you have any questions between the two, let me know. I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.